Okay, question three is pretty much a test of your algebra. A function f is defined by the set of real numbers given by f of x is x over 1 take x, and you have this here, not really part of the sum, they're just pointing out that x is not allowed to be 1 because that would give you 1 take 1, that would give you 0 in the bottom. So they're just pointing out that x can't be 1, but apart from that, you can just ignore that. They're asking for f of x. So f of x is f of x over 1 take x, that's that one there. And how do you do that? Well, you replace that whole function everywhere you see an x there, both places, okay? So we have x over 1 take x, that's that function put there, over 1 take x over 1 take x, 1 take, and that's we put that whole function there. Okay, now we have some reasonably difficult algebra. That one, I'm just calling 1 take x over 1 take x. Why? Because it now gives me a common denominator of 1 take x. Okay, so we have, here we have x over 1 take x, not really doing anything to that. But down here, we have 1 take x over what is now a common denominator. 1 take x over 1 take x. And that's now simplifying a little bit now, because we have x over 1 take x, which I've not done anything to. 1 take 2x over 1 take x. Now just tidying it up here. What's x over 1 take x divided by 1 take 2x over 1 take x? Well, it's x over 1 take x times, and you invert this round, 1 take x over 1 take 2x. The x's cancel out, and you're left with x over 1 take 2x.